And I wanted to show you the amount of weapons all around here that this vigilante group has obtained. The government has sort of endorsed them now, but this is a very bizarre model for sure. ¿Y qué tipo de arma es esa?
Esta es una Pietro Beretta.
¿Es la tuya personal?
Esta es la mía personal. Esta es la que yo cargo. De hecho, diario la traigo puesta y ahora no me la puse. No sé.
So we've just arrived in Morelia, which is the capital of the state of Michoacán. One of the most important drug dealers of Mexico was captured a few days ago. And we want to see what happens now that this leader is gone. Many people say, as you know, that drug trafficking is like a beast with many heads. Once you chop one of the heads off, there's another one that's going to pop up. And we want to see on the ground how this is affecting Michoacán.
Traveling in these roads and the rural areas of these states can be pretty sketchy, so that's why we rented a family minivan, because we were told not to rent an SUV or a Toyota or any flashy car, because that's what drug traffickers use. So obviously we don't want to attract too much attention or be stopped by the police or by drug gangs. That would be even worse. There are several vigilante groups, and some of them have become drug traffickers themselves. Others are just citizens who took up arms because they didn't trust the police, and that's the people we're going to see right now. They are still armed and are patrolling the streets themselves, so we're going to see if we can go on a patrol with them.
¿Qué tal? Buenas tardes.
Buenas.
¿Cómo
estás?
Bien.
Para acá somos buenos.
Pero la tranquilidad de la gente, ya salen, ya vienen a sus eventos.
Por ejemplo, ¿esto no se veía
antes? Esto no se veía antes.
¿Hace cuánto no se veía?
No, pues ya teníamos como unos 10 años. Que sacamos los templares, aquí ya la vida ya cambió. Este es el resultado de la lucha de todos nosotros. Y del pueblo, pues, principalmente. Aquí están los muchachos dándole la seguridad, por allá están otros. Mira, aquí está un compañero elemento de civil que también es, él también es autoridad, igual que nosotros. Ahí trae su mochilita también a la expectativa.
So there's many people here who are armed. Not all of them are wearing the uniform, he says, but they're all sort of supervising the event. These guys that you see here, they're pretty hardcore. I mean, you see them laughing and sort of relaxed, but they got some of these weapons from the Knights Templars. They stole it from them. So it shows you a bit of how they were, how they behaved.
And I wanted to show you the amount of weapons all around here that this vigilante group has obtained. The government has sort of endorsed them now, but this is a very bizarre model for sure.
¿Cómo obtuvieron estas armas?
El gobierno los armó. Son armas del gobierno.
O sea, ustedes ahora son gobierno.
Policía estatal, fuerza rural. Somos gobierno ya ahorita. Yo nunca pensé ser policía.
Claro.
Jamás en mi vida pasó por mi mente.
¿Cuál es la tuya? ¿Cuál es tu arma?
45.
Número 45. Número 45. ¿Y qué tipo de arma es esa?
Esta es una Pietro Beretta.
¿Es la tuya personal?
Esta es la mía personal. Esta es la que yo cargo. De hecho, diario la traigo puesta y ahora no me la puse. No sé.
Buenas noches.
These men are patrolling 24 hours a day. So clearly, you know, things are still tense. And they're basically looking out for anybody who's suspicious, for anybody they don't recognize and could be perhaps working for the Knights Templar still. I think they're very keen to show us that things are under control in town and that it's calm, but it's very hard to tell in Mexico when things are calm or when, you know, they're about to get very violent again. In other countries, like Colombia, for example, with a lot of drug trafficking activities, every time that citizens have armed themselves and constituted these kind of self-defense groups, it's really been a recipe for disaster, because they've gotten out of control, and that's the question, if they're gonna get too powerful or not.